When the rich need someone to fight their wars, they get the people that can't afford to go to college, that need health care for their families, that need a home. That's who they send. You know, going to Iraq in 2003, believing what I was told, that we're going to help the Iraqi people, to bring them a better life, to defend our friends and family back at home. It took 12 months occupying that country of seeing young children crying hysterically as we ripped them from their homes, of seeing a man shot through the neck, brought to a prison cell instead of being brought to a hospital, seeing men sob uncontrollably and urinate themselves in detention facilities during interrogation. All of that pain and suffering made me see that there is no way in hell that this was a war of liberation. This was something else. And what I was a part of was defined at the Nuremberg trials as the most supreme crime against humanity, and that's the illegal war of aggression against a sovereign nation. In that war, over 1 million Iraqis were killed. Over 1 million human beings perished, not including the million that died before in Iraq as a result of the sanctions and the bombings by the United States. But 1 million died and are still dying. For what? For a war based on lies. You know, we are told that there is this threat of weapons of mass destruction, and not only did it turn out that there were no weapons of mass destruction, but that when the politicians and the generals were presenting the evidence, that they knew that it was fabricated. They knew that it was a lie. And they sold it to us anyway. They sent thousands of us to our deaths, tens of thousands to be maimed, hundreds of thousands, perhaps over 1 million, to be psychologically traumatized. But you know, the Iraq War is not out of character for the US government. It's nothing new. They actually lie quite a bit. They lied about the Gulf War being to protect the people of Kuwait. They lied about the Vietnam War being to bring democracy to the Vietnamese people. And they lied about every single popular democratic government that they overthrew and installed the most brutal dictator, whether it be in Haiti or Chile or Iran or the countless other examples through US history. And they're lying to us right now as we're launching these very expensive cruise missiles into Libya. I think if we saw these pictures just now, you know, how dare the US government even utter the words humanitarian intervention? You know, we're supposed to believe it's just a coincidence that Libya is Africa's largest oil producer. They're telling us that we have to be in Afghanistan to protect our friends and our family here at home. You know, we're supposed to believe it's just a coincidence that Afghanistan would give the US military machine a foothold in the most strategic and important resource-rich region on the entire planet, one that they had long hoped to dominate and actually tried to develop quite friendly relationships with the Taliban government at the time, with these, you know, plans for oil pipelines and so forth. Now, all of these wars from the beginning of this country are based on lies and deceptions. They keep sending those soldiers to be killed, to be blown up, because they don't want to take the responsibility of a political setback, of tarnishing the image of the invincible empire. And so that's why we say to those in the US military that you have the absolute right to refuse your orders to deploy to Afghanistan and Iraq. And that's absolutely what you should do. And if you want to fight for what's really in our interest, fight to end the wars and fight to use all of that money, that $700 million a day, to meet human need here at home.